Hi, I'm Alex Dunelow from the Google Developer Relations team. One of the things I found really hard as a web developer is making compelling animations on a site. It seems easy enough at first to throw some CSS animations onto a site and watch the browser fly stuff around you and you feel all chuffed when you first see it. But if you're like me, you want to make your site really stand out, you know, be memorable, not just another pre-canned clone of something people have already seen. So I started experimenting with different web animation techniques and right away hit problems with doing fancy things. Like, for example, I wanted to make two things animate in perfect sync, but couldn't find a way to do it really easily. My solution took 1,000 lines of code and was extremely choppy and riddled with jank. If only there was a better way. Now, this is the kind of thing I wanted to build, a 3D hardware-accelerated view of the world with silky smooth, jank-free animation and total control. Well, now there is a better way. A bunch of browser writers and animation experts got together a couple of years ago to look at this with a fresh set of eyes. Lots of eyes, in fact. We spent a lot of time discussing what web developers need, how animation designers work, and a whole lot more. What we came up with is Web Animations 1.0. We aim to take all the existing web animation primitives out there and unify them, and also bring new capabilities that weren't just more powerful, but would run faster and smoother as a result. Now, one of the best APIs to play with animation from JavaScript is, of course, Request Animation Frame, especially if you want fine-grained control of everything that's happening on a frame-by-frame basis. So let's take a quick look at how animation works when you use Request Animation Frame. Now, using Request Animation Frame gives great control, but forces JavaScript execution on every frame. Now, this is fine if you're not doing much in your JavaScript, but we only have 16 milliseconds for each frame, and that includes paint and layout time too. So if you run out of time, you know what happens? Skipped frames, resulting in jank, which some people call jitter. Now, this is the main reason it's a good idea to decouple the animations from JavaScript execution itself. So we wanted the flexibility of control from JavaScript, but not the jank, and so this is what we designed. The Web Animations API lets you create animations from JavaScript, then offload the animation calculations to the browser so it can take care of all the heavy lifting for you. And in many cases, it can take advantage of hardware acceleration, so there's very little work to do for each frame. Now, what this means, it enables proper hardware-accelerated animations to happen via the use of a JavaScript API, but without the slowdown from recalculating lots of stuff each frame. This is something we didn't have before, which is pretty cool, huh? I know what you're thinking. Yeah, but we already have CSS animations that are hardware-accelerated. Right, well, that's true. And by unifying everything, we extend the reach of hardware acceleration. The web animations design brings together CSS animations, transitions, SVG animation, and JavaScript-created animations all into one thing. In fact, the web animations engine is currently used to run both CSS animations and transitions in Chrome. You probably didn't even notice when that happened, and that's testament to how seamlessly the web animations engine integrates into browsers. Now, even better is that in addition to powering CSS animations, you can call element.animate, which creates an animation player object that's used to interface to the animation internals inside the browser. Now, the object return lets you query and modify the running animation, so you get decoupled running of animation in the browser, but retain the ability to modify running animation from JavaScript, kind of the best of both worlds. Now, remember this? The cool 3D globe's actually built using web animations. Bet you didn't guess that. And it's just the tip of the iceberg. Here's another demo which shows how you can manipulate a running animation using input like touch. Now, you can't build something like this using CSS animation, since there's no way to dynamically manipulate a running animation once it's started. But with web animations, you can. And here's another which shows true synchronization, something almost everyone I've talked to is excited about. Web animations are so cool, and you can use them right now. Not only does Chrome have native support for web animations, but we launched an open source implementation in JavaScript, which lets you use the API in any modern browser. That polyfill lets you use web animations right away, and we're doing all of this work in public at the W3C to make sure all browser vendors are on board. So take a look at the polyfill, the demos, hack through the code, make your site shine with the most powerful animation primitives available to web developers today. I know you'll blow people's socks off. I'm Alex Dunelow, and I'm excited to see what kinds of things you'll build using web animations.